for my little crafty shop. You can find Lisa on all these social media platforms. Also, I have a discount code, which is Dina10, and you get 10% off your total purchase. Okay, so my share today is going to be die cuts that are words. But before I get started on that, and then also at the very end, I will, if you're interested, I will show you the items that I use for these particular projects. So first of all, Lisa has in her shop these sentiment packs, okay? So the sentiment packs have so many adorable little sentiments inside here. She has the cutest little sayings. Some of them say, pick your poison, fabulous, happy Halloween, bad witch, wicked, hey pumpkin, witch please, hey ghoul friend. And so what I've decided to do is, just to make some of the sentiments pop, I've already added some of them with some foam and popped them up on foam dots. So this is what they will look like once you decide to pop them up. Okay, so I have those. And then she also has, okay, so the colors that she has these more vibrant Halloween colors, and then she also has them in pastel colors. Okay, and then she has these Christmas sentiment packs that also come in some pastels and then traditional colors. I did not pop those up, but I was just going to mention that you can use the white ones and then go around with a marking pen and then add a little border to them. Okay, so those are some of the sentiments that she has in her shop. Now, what I'm going to be sharing today is her Christmas dies. We have mistletoe, caroling, Santa's helper, elf, tinsel, and yuletide. Okay, and I just put a couple of these on here. A lot of them say tinsel and a lot of them say elf. I just figured it was easier just to pull those ones out. And so I just wanted to kind of share with you what they look like with different alternating backgrounds, whether it be mirrored paper. Well, those aren't really mirrored. I guess those are just more like a metallic. So metallic paper on just regular paper, colored paper, and then some with glittered paper. And so I just thought I'd share that. And I thought this one was really, this one's like so perfect. So I have this one set, this one collection called Candy Christmas. And I thought these two colors would match perfect because that one kind of stands out like a sore thumb. So I just wanted to verify what it's going with so that you guys, what it's going with so that you guys don't just look at it and think, oh my gosh, that's kind of weird. Okay. And then her other die set that she has are the Halloween words. And you have beautiful, you have candy, you have wicked, and then you have witch. Okay. And again, here are a couple samples of those. So I made one that looks like candy corn. I have the one that's just glittered cardstock. I have some that are just regular cardstock right here with foam on them. And then here is a glittered background with glitter on top. So I just thought I would share those. Okay. Alrighty, so let me go ahead and share my projects. So the first project is this memory decks I made. It is made with, well, I'll share, like I said, the dies afterwards, but I ended up using a bow die. I didn't make a bow, of course, but I have a bow that makes a bat bow, a witch, and then a spider. And so I ended up using the spider web for the background. I also used another spider web memory decks die, but of course it's not a memory decks. I just wanted the actual spider web to be coming out of the top. this is an image that I had downloaded and I just went ahead and fussy cut. This is the word wicket from Lisa's collection. This is a bat that's just a foam bat that I also die cut. And then there was some ribbon in my stash that I got from a de-stash a long time ago. And then I ended up using one of my rosette, crepe paper rosettes that I did a multiple color with. And so this is Mulan. And so I went ahead and made that. Okay, so that's the first project. Okay, and then my second project are these little boxes. Okay, so more images that I just found online and I went ahead and fussy cut. I have some cobweb dies that are in my stash, so I went ahead and cut one out in the gold and then cut one out in a holographic. They're actually both kind of holographic, I guess. One's a holographic gold and one's a holographic silver. Then I used the word elf, which you can see it didn't necessarily have to be used for Christmas. You can actually use it for Halloween as well. And on my little boxes, okay, so I cut my boxes out. I don't know if you can see that, but there is like a glittered finish. I have some mixture that I ended up mixing with alcohol, some eyelash, no, I'm sorry. I was gonna say eyelash trim. I mixed it with some alcohol and some eyeshadow and, hairspray, I believe. And, so I made my own little concoction here. And so I sprayed that on. And like I said, I don't know if you can see that there's a little bit of a shimmer. Then I did some paint splatters with some metallic green. I went ahead and fussy cut, well, not fussy cut, but I just cut this down to size to fit on here, just to give it some more stability. And then they're just little boxes to fit, ready to fit little goodies in. So I did two of those and I did them both, I did them both the same. So those are my projects that I had created. And the dies that I ended up using for these particular projects were this one right here, which is a Halloween bow die. You have the cobweb right here, and then the bat that I ended up using from this one. I ended up using this memory dex right here that was from AliExpress. I also used this memory dex cobweb as well. And I believe that one was from AliExpress also. And then I used this cobweb right here. That was an AliExpress cobweb. And then I ended up using this tonic box right here. That makes just the cutest little box. And I got this a couple years ago. In 2019 at Tuesday morning. Okay, so those are the items that I used for this project. I think they turned out really super cute and they're super Halloween colored. But I want to say thank you guys so much for watching and I appreciate you and thank you so much for always supporting me and I hope you all have a wonderful day. Bye guys.